Hello, everybody. How's it going? It is Easter. Happy Easter. I don't know when this will get uploaded because all my uploads are very late. I still have videos on my capturing device from probably up to 4 months ago. And, yeah, I know, that's kind of sad. I just didn't upload anything lately. But I got a live commentary here on WMD. It's Demolition. And, yes, I've been playing a lot of Demolition lately. But I still can't really pick my favorite game type, because I don't really have one. So I covered my teammate while he planted at B. And, if you're not planting, you definitely want to cover. And, so we're just gonna, I'm just gonna be talking about some tips. Right here, we get the enemies weren't too smart because they all came for B while my teammates planted at A. That's how we roll. And, so yeah, if I were you on WMD, I would send half the team to B. Half the team to A, place a claymore by this door right there. That should always get somebody. And right when the timer gets down to about 10 seconds, just take off, go cover A. But they did defuse A, so not a big deal though. And I can't believe I died. I was 5-0, dang it. No, whatever though. So my kill streaks I normally use are either 5-9, 5-7-9, or 5-6-7, and those kill streaks would be the kill streaks. Well, I can't even think of it right now. Kill streaks are those. That would be what? Napalm, sentry gun, and napalm, sentry gun, and attack helicopter, and I just burnt myself, man. I just got a nice little triple there, if you couldn't see. I mean, if you didn't see. But I could have easily got another napalm, but I freaking died. How sad is that? So, the host would leave right when the bomb destroys. But, so yeah, as you can see, we did that in under 3 minutes. And, pretty nice and easy. Didn't take much effort, but I would definitely use napalm strike, and then you can either I'd use attack helicopter too, but sentry gun and chopper gunner, that's your decision, because you can destroy both of them. Like, you can't destroy a napalm strike, but you can destroy attack helicopter, but I would still use it. But it's your decision whether you want to use sentry gun or chopper gunner, or you could even use a gunship or whatever. Actually, I really don't care what you use. I'm just giving you my suggestion, because the sentry gun, if you have hacker on, you can easily destroy that, but you have to place it in a good spot. So yeah, my teammate would give away a position by shooting at me. But now for perks, I use flak jacket, sleight of hand, and marathon. Because marathon is nice to get from one bomb site to another. And also, it is it just makes you run fast or longer, actually. Sleight of hand pro, when you're in those tight situations, you can reload pretty fast. And flak jacket, if you're gonna be planting the bomb at all, or like right there, I hit a guy with flak jacket and he didn't die. If you're going to be planting the bomb at all, you're going to want to use flak jacket, because they're going to chuck grenades in there. They're going to have claymores. They're going to have grenade launchers. They're going to have rocket launchers. They're going to have everything fired at you, and you're going to want to survive. So, flak jacket is the way to do that. And you always want, I would definitely use as equipment either C4 or claymore, because with C4, you can set C4 down. And while the enemy is, you can always watch, and if the bomb site is flashing, it says it means that the enemy is planting, which means you can, destroy your C4. And with Claymore, you can just place it near the bomb site, and that will detonate
on contact.
But again, a lot of people use flak jackets, so it depends. And this enemy team, wow, we defused it. Nice. This enemy team is doing the same thing that we're doing, and so I just choose to let B go and just go all out for A. Because B's pretty much a goner. But A, we still gotta protect A. So yeah. Which is what I do. It's what I do. So yeah. That guy in there is racking up a kill streak off of us. But if the bomb site's almost destroyed, you wanna get to the other bomb site, because in time the enemy's just gonna destroy it. And wow, this guy like really stinks. He's just got an SR-71 Blackbird, which is retarded. Yes, he killed him, yay. Flashed him and he got him. See, teamwork right there. Oh shoot. They got like a chopper gunner or something. So I want to defuse this as soon as I can. Ah! Yeah, you would kill him right when he killed me. So, Ghost Pro is also nice, though, because the enemy can't really see you. But, we shot down the helicopter. Which is always good. You always want someone on your teammate. You want communication. Someone's got to have a backup as some kind of rocket launcher. So that you can, you know, take down... Good job, guys. So you can take down, enemy aircraft. Because they're going to want to throw everything at you. They're going to throw attack helicopters... spy planes, counter spy planes, all that junk. So I'm actually switching to my AK-74U class. I always seem to do better with that. I always seem to do better with this class, but I don't really use it much I do use it much. I was just using the AUG because I unlocked it recently and I wanted to see what it does. So, for game types like this, for game types like capture the flag, demolition, domination, I don't care about my KDR. I care about helping my teammates for the objective. That's what I care about. So, you're not going to see my KDR real high, which it is not. I have 14 kills and 17 deaths. Obviously, that's not really good. But... I have defended the bomb and stuff, so. And, that's really all that matters. All you people who are, I'm not trying to hate or anything, but all you people who are only worried about your KDR and stuff, yeah, that's pretty lame, because there's a lot more to, if you're worried about your KDR, play like team deathmatch or free for all or something, but you know, not a team based game. You go play free for all or something. Sorry for the background noise. My uncle and my dad are watching a hockey game, and there's thunder. Oh, stuck him. Nice. Not bad. That was actually pretty cool. He was like moving up to shoot me and I stuck him. So, I think we got this. So, yeah, already I'm doing better by using my AK-74U. This is about maybe one of two submachine guns I actually like. I'm not a big fan of submachine guns. I'm into more assault rifles. But this is as strong as an assault rifle. They just don't classify it as it. They don't classify it as an assault rifle because of the range. Yeah. I wouldn't really use sniper rifles for team-based games for the most part, but there's nothing wrong with it. And see, that's a good place for a sentry gun. And I also wouldn't use, like, light machine guns. But, they're okay, depending on how you use them. So, yeah. That is game. I think it's wrapping up right now. So, I would like to thank you for watching. And please rate this video. Please comment and please subscribe. It really helps a lot. A lot, guys. Just comment. Tell me what you think. Because it does help. And rating and liking and subscribing is the best. And favorited if you like this video. It doesn't have to be your favorite, but you can like it and favorite it. So, thank you guys for watching. Please rate, comment, subscribe, like. I always say rate because I'm so used to the 5-star rating, but whatever. That changed a while ago. Peace out.